All right, so we told you she was coming. She's finally here. She woke up early and stumbled into our studio. She's a Nigerian singer. You know her. She's Seyi Shay. And she's here this morning to give us a performance of her latest single,
Alili.
The song is off her titled album EP titled Electric Package. And she's going to deliver that package to us in all its energy this morning, Seyi Shay.
I'll try.
It's so good to see you this morning.
Me too.
All right.
Arriba, arriba. You know, say now we dey run nobody. Now we dey one for logo. You can't be sitting when the girl is on the microphone. As you see me coming out the bugae, you see me coming out the zugae. Me not see anybody. All I wanna do is chop up my money. Follow me legally.
Joshua, professionally known as Seyi Shay. Yes, I did it.
Yeah.
Yes, you can kill me later. A Nigerian-based singer, songwriter is in the studio.
Yeah, she, in 2005, she signed a record deal with Island Records and released her debut studio album, Seyi or Shay. Mm. And she gave us a really good performance earlier on the show, and now it's time to find out what she's been up to.
Yeah.
With a new EP and stuff. I feel overdressed for this interview.
Welcome to the occasion, really.
Welcome, yeah. Seyi.
Thank you.
In all your grandeur and splendor. Welcome.
Thank you.
No, but really, really, Seyi, amazing work.
Thank you.
You've been doing quite a lot of amazing things. In the past year, you know, I've been looking out for you, and I know that you're working on something for the youth, I think, even a scholarship. That was just amazing. But so music-wise, this new song, talk to us about it.
Okay, well, let me just tell you how things really went in order.
Yeah.
So towards the end of last year, I you know, I had released like 2-3 songs since January. After Yolo Yolo, I put out an international song with my label, For Your Matter, featuring Yuji. And then I now released another one called Weekend Vibes, featuring Sarkodie. Mm. Then I had a few months kind of off, just sort of reconfiguring my life, pretty much.
Okay.
And then I landed a role, a lead role in a movie called Lara and the Beat by Biola Alabi Studios. And so I worked with a director and a whole team from Los Angeles on this movie, starring myself, Som Kele, and Vector, Viper. And I spent 3 months on set because it was actually a really intense movie. And that will be out later this year. And so after that took me up until December. In December, I expanded my management team. And I, you know, went to, after the NEA Awards, came back to Nigeria and embarked on the making of this EP, which I call Electric Package.
Okay.
Because of that
thing that happened.
That stunt that happened some years ago. Okay. They tried to like crucify me because I was asked, what does EP mean? And I mean, I said Electric Package. And all the people that were crucifying me had no idea what EP meant.
Of course.
Nobody in Nigeria.
Because it was like, oh, she doesn't know what EP means. And then I'm Googling what EP means.
Not even that, even Google. Like, just somebody just said, ah, there, come on, got it. This one now said, hey, it's yours. Now everybody now joined. Well, now, they now put their mouth and nose and everything in. And like, obviously, that trended for a while. So I decided to flip it on them and call my EP
Electric Package.
Electric Package. Right.
Nice. I was actually a bit confused, like Electric Package. I didn't know what to expect, but this breakdown just does it for me.
Yeah, I call it Electric Package. 6 songs featuring 6 DJs from around Africa and a few artists from around Africa.
6 DJs.
Very nice.
6, that's a lot of work. Okay, so how did you go about picking the DJs, the artists, who you were going to partner with?
Well, the song I just performed for you right now features DJ Consequence. Okay. And it sounds like something that he would have you know, like really liked to be on. And when he heard it, he was like, I'll jump on that. Flavor too. And then we have like people like Neptune, DJ Cuppy, DJ Spinall.
Was there a particular reason why you picked DJs? You know, because I feel
I feel like DJs are always slept on.
Yeah, because you know they're usually always in the background and that stuff.
All right, I'm thinking, you know, you have the kind of voice that you can use to do ballads, you can use to do, you know, so many different types of music, but it does feel like you're leaning towards
dance.
This Afro calypso kind of sound. Is there a reason for that?
Because everybody wants to dance. Everybody likes to dance. Everybody likes to feel happy. And so I feel like Yolo Yolo was like, for me, just like the sign.
Okay.
That's where I needed to stay. Because I'm just generally a happy, bubbly person. I'm loud. I'm like, you know, let's dance. Let's do this. Let's do that. And then, so if I'm making music that's like really somber and down and everything, kind of defeats my who I really am.
Okay.
I wanted to take you back a little bit to late last year when you said you took some time off to just, you know, rearrange things. So tell us about that. I know that it's very personal for you, but tell us why you needed to probably redirect your energies.
Well, because I wanted to do a bit more. I wanted to be more involved with like my work, my music firsthand. I needed to take the bull by the horns, as it were. Yeah. So I needed to, you know, get myself a new team. Like I needed to get myself a manager because, like, for the longest time, I've been micromanaging everything, right? Okay. But I had the opportunity of meeting somebody called Kamal Ajiboye, who was formerly the manager of Davido. And when we met on the set of the movie that I had just finished filming, we had a long, in-depth conversation. And I realized that he had a wealth of knowledge of the industry. I realized that he was a very well-respected guy, and he just knew exactly what I needed, what I wanted to do with my music. And so.
Okay. All right, so you know, working with Kamal now, does it give you a bigger, brighter perspective?
Definitely, because I'm able now to like offset a lot you know, that I used to handle myself before.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And now I can just focus on the music. I spent like 3 months just making music. Mm. I ended up like 20-something records and picked only six. Do you understand?
Right. Wow.
So it's like...
You wouldn't have been able to do that.
I wouldn't have been able to do that in my past situations.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. So in all this, now, we're not getting any younger. I say we for a reason.
Yeah.
So let's talk relationships now. Is there any special someone out there? Because we never really hear about that. You know, we don't talk about that online much.
Anybody, nobody talks about it.
Well, I'm not sure
just
they're talking
me.
About it. So talk to us. Is there anyone special out there? What do you have plans for when it comes to settling down?
I think just being a young lady at my age and in this country, I'm expected to have already settled down, what X, Y, Z. But I believe that you can do both. You can have both. Mm-hmm. But I also believe that it's very easy to get married to the wrong person.
Okay.
So that when you now get married, 1 year later, you're already fighting or something or divorce. Because that happens a lot in my generation, like, and a lot nowadays.
Yeah.
So I don't want that for my life. And I would rather, because it will have a double effect on me, my music and my personal life. So let me just, you know, round up properly.
Of course.
You know, with my music and my career, going to other things, and the right person, if he's there already, he understands what to do and how to do it, and then we'll be fine. God's time is the best time.
Yeah. So 2018 is looking like a big year with the movie coming out.
Yeah.
So are you going to be doing more movies, or this is just like one off for you?
Well, the movie comes out in July, cinemas everywhere, and. I had the opportunity to see a few clips, a few trailers.
How did it feel?
Oh my God. I'm like, wow, is that me? So what a lot of people don't understand, or I shouldn't be saying too much about it, but you guys will get the full gist soon. But what a lot of people didn't realize while we were filming is that I wasn't actually acting.
That was really you.
Oh, right.
Really?
Okay. So when you watch the movie, you understand.
Yeah. Okay.
So they're like, you're such an amazing actress, Seyi. I'm like, I've never acted before. This is not acting. This is just...
Right.
So, I would read a few of the lines and then memorize a few lines. They call it slides or sides. Sorry, sides. And I read it in four lines. Okay, great. Action. Oh, yeah. And then I would just like... But it's like, it was also like it was written. The movie was written for me. Even them casting Vector, who is, an old friend of mine, and then casting so many people that I already knew. It was really weird. It's almost like...
All right.